गुड मॉर्निंग माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू माई क्लास. सो इन साइंस वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आर नेक्स्ट लेसन. दिस इज लेसन 8 फॉर आर सेकेंड यूनिट एग्जामिनेशन. सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट लेसन 8. दिस इज मटेरियल्स एंड सॉल्यूशंस. ओके, इन दिस लेसन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी about solution and its components, soluble and insoluble substances, methods of separation of soluble and insoluble substances. Basically we are going to deal with these three topics. Okay, so let us start the lesson. We have already studied in the previous class that most of the substances dissolve in water to form a solution. Let's learn more about solutions in this chapter. So in this chapter we are going to learn about solutions, more about solutions. Already you see the name of the lesson is materials and solutions. All right, okay. So you see here water, water is an universal solvent. You will see most of the things they dissolve in water. Okay, so you see here most of the substances dissolve in water. Why? Because just now I told you that water is an universal solvent. All right, now in the later part we are going to study about solute, solvent, solutions, all these things we are going to study later. All right, okay, so now let us start solution and its components. So what is a solution? Actually, solution is a type of liquid mixture in which two or more substances mix together evenly. Okay, it is a type of liquid mixture, solution. All right, when you mix, like you are taking water, you are mixing salt in it. All right, when you are mixing both the things, you see here, when you that is a mixture is happening in which two or more substances mix together evenly. You cannot see them. Okay, that is a solution. A solution mainly consists of two components. What are they? Two things. Components means things. A solute and a solvent. You see here in this picture how a solution formation is being done. You see a solute plus solvent equal to solution. Okay, so suppose we take like the solute is let us take it as salt. Okay, the solute is salt. The solvent is water. So when you are mixing salt plus water, what is the thing that is being formed? That is known as solution. All right, so you please see here we already studied about solution. All right, now the substance that dissolves is called solute. We took the example of salt, that is the solute, while the other substance in which the solute dissolves is called solvent. What it is known as? Like if we are taking water, that is the solvent. Okay, solute substances can be solids, liquids or gases. So solute that you are mixing, okay, that can be solids, that can be liquids, and that can be gases also. Okay, the solvents are generally liquid. So you see here the solvent, that is liquid, generally liquid. You can take the example of water, milk, alcohol. Okay, these things are, this are all solvents. All right, and they are generally liquid. Okay, the quantity of solvent in a solution is always more than the quantity of solute. So the quantity of solvent in a solution is always more. The solvent will be more if you compare it with the solute. All right, is always more than the quantity of the solute. Because suppose we are taking only, suppose we are mixing sugar and water. So the sugar is the solute. All right, we take one spoon, teaspoon of sugar in a cup of water, isn't it, or in a glass of water. So the solvent is always more, the quantity of solvent is always more. But we cannot differentiate between these two substances in the solution. But when the solution is formed, when we are mixing both the substances, that is sugar plus water, we cannot differentiate between these two substances. Okay, The ability of a substance to dissolve is called solubility. So what is solubility? When you are mixing both the substances, that is solubility. The ability of a substance to dissolve is called solubility. All right? You see in this image, mixture. What is a mixture? It is a combination of two or more substances that keep their properties and can be easily separated. That is a mixture. Okay? What is the solution? Here we are talking about solution. So what is a solution? A mixture where one substance is dissolved into another substance. That is a mixture. That is a solution. A mixture where one substance is dissolved into another substance. That is a solution. And what is dissolved? When a solid is mixed into a liquid and spreads out evenly until the particles are too small to see. Okay. Now let me explain you the from mixture. A combination of two or more substances. Suppose you are mixing two substances or more than two substances that keep their properties and can be easily separated. We are going to, in the later part of the lesson, we are going to study about, suppose we are mixing salt and water. How can we separate salt from water? Suppose we are mixing sugar plus water. How can we separate sugar from water? So we are going to learn in the later part of the lesson. All these things we are going to learn. Okay. It is a combination of two or more substances that keep their properties and can be easily separated. Okay. Now let us come to solution. Here we studied about solution in this lesson, that a mixture where one substance is dissolved into another substance. We took the example of salt plus water. So the mixture, the solution that will be formed. Okay. If we take sugar plus water, the solution that will be formed. All right. What is dissolved? When a solid is mixed into a liquid, when a solid is mixed into a liquid and spreads out unevenly until the particles are too small to see. Suppose we are mixing sugar in water. Can we see the sugar? We cannot see because it mixes up well with the water. We cannot see the sugar in the water. It becomes the particles, they spread out evenly and the particles, they become too small to see. We cannot see with our eyes. All right? That is dissolved. When a solid is mixed into a liquid and spreads out evenly until the particles are too small to see. You can see in this image, salt is the solute. Okay, water is the solvent. And salt water, that is formed by mixing both this salt and water, that is the solution. All right? A solute is a substance that is added to a solvent to form a solution. You see here, solute is a substance that is added to a solvent to form a solution. The solution that is formed. You can see here, salt water is the solution that is formed by mixing salt and water. See here now. For example, when we mix some common salt in water, we cannot see the salt particles after the solution is made. Okay, so when we mix some common salt in water, if we mix salt in water, we cannot see the salt particles. When the solution is already being made, we cannot see the salt. Okay, this is because salt dissolves evenly in water. It has the property, the salt has the property to dissolve in water. So it dissolves evenly in water, making a salt solution. And if you taste that water, in that water, the taste of salt will come. It will become a salt solution. In the given example, common salt is the solute. Water is the solvent and the salt water formed is the solution. Just now we discussed. Some other examples of solutions in our everyday life are mixing of sugar in milk and mixing of coffee powder in milk. Okay. You may see your parents taking tea. Okay, so in tea, you just imagine what are the things mixed up in tea. Okay, mixing of sugar in milk. Small children, you all take milk. So your mommy mixes a tablespoon of sugar in milk. Okay, and mixing of coffee powder in milk. Did you ever notice that when we think about a solution, we always think about water? Whenever this comes in our mind, whenever we think about a solution, we always think about water, because water is an universal solvent. Okay? Now you see, this is because water is a good solvent since it dissolves a variety of substances easily than any other liquid. So water has the property to dissolve a variety of substances easily. Okay, hence it is called a universal solvent. So water is known as a universal solvent. All right, soluble and insoluble substances. Now we are going to discuss about soluble and insoluble substances. But before that, let me show you one image. You see here, solvent, solute and solution. Okay, you can see that water plus lemonade mix equal to lemonade. If you mix water plus lemonade mix, it will the solution that will be formed, that will be lemonade. Okay, then iced tea plus sugar. Okay, if you mix both, the solution that will be formed is sweet tea. Okay, if you make mix milk plus chocolate sauce, so the solution that will be formed, that is chocolate milk. All right, okay.